But first, please put your hands together, everybody in the studio, for that most wonderful band, Cypress Hill, with their new single, Insane.
On the flam, boy and temper, just toss that ham in the frying pan like spam. Get done when I come and slam. Damn, I feel like the son of Sam. Don't make me wreck shit. Hectic, next to the tag, got me going like General Electric. And the lights are blinking. I'm thinking it's all over when I go out drinking. Oh, making my mind slow. That's why I'm not fucking with the big 4-0, bro. I got to maintain.
The Cypress Hill is going insane.
Insane in the membrane.
I don't take a damn thing like this. Sources tell us cause they can't outfight me. Pick that star, wake it, wow. Face nigga never seen me smile. Rip that mainframe, I'll explain. Send dog is going insane.
Insane in the membrane.
Insane in the brain.
Get out there, we're insane in the membrane.
Insane in the brain.
Yes, we're insane in the membrane.
Louis Armstrong played the trumpet, I'll hit that bong and break you all something soon. I got to get my props. Cops come and try to snatch my crops. These pigs wanna blow my house down. Head underground to the next town. They get mad when they come to raid my pad. And I'm out in the nine deuce cat. Yes, I'm the pirate pilot of this ship. If I dip with the ultraviolet
dream,
I'm from the red light beam. Now they don't believe in the unseen.
Look,
don't make your eyes strain.
Cypress Hill is going insane.
Insane in the membrane.
Insane in the brain.
Yes, we're insane in the membrane.
Insane in the brain.
You know that we're insane in the membrane.
Crazy insane, got no brain.
Insane in the membrane.
I think we're going crazy.
Cypress Hill, Insane in the Brain.
You feel stoned?
Yeah, no, you were all right. You were quite into that.
I love that.
Do you think all that kind of, you know, California's taking over now from New York as the home of rap music?
Well, you know, it's not the home. It's the continuation. It's the future. It's going forward. And the Long Beach sound is definitely big. You got Cypress Hill. You got Snoop Dogg. You got Domino. It's coming. It's the next wave. But then it's going to pass to another city.
Oh, well, listen, they're coming up here now. Be Real and Send Dog of Cypress Hill.
All right.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Give him a round of applause.
You
got
in here. Hi, how you doing?
How you doing?
Good.
Very nice to meet you.
Come on over here.
Oh, yeah, move.
Oh, yes.
We'll just scoot in.
Oh, right, you're going to get in the middle there, are you?
I'm in that Cypress Hill sandwich.
Hey, well, it's all right.
Oh, that's all. They'll be getting that on camera. Listen, they're getting on for 4 million albums now sold worldwide. I mean, it's kind of been quite, in a way, overnight success in those terms, international terms. Were you quite surprised at that?
Yeah, we were, because, like, our first album was called Cypress Hill, named after our group, and it took a while for it to happen. So when this new album called Black Sunday, you know, hit the top of the charts, we were like, whoa, you know, we were bugged out, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it was kind of surprising to us that it would do so well. So in such a quick amount of time, because the first one did very slowly on the underground on the first one. So this one, we poured a lot of frustration into it and people ended up relating to it, so, you know.
Why is it you think that, you know, rap now has gone really big and yet in some ways the lyrics have got harder, yet if you listen to stuff like Scott La Rock, KRS-One, you know, in the sort of early days of hip-hop, that kind of never went as big, it never went international?
Well, I think, see, on the level that hip-hop was a few years ago, a lot of people made it for only hip-hop audiences, you know? And when we came on the scene, we didn't want to leave anyone out. So we did music and lyrics that people all around the world have been through, you know, experiences. And I think everyone relates to, you know, personal experiences.
But what about the soundtrack for Judgment Night?
Judgment Night?
Yeah.
That was more like a fun thing, you know. We wanted to do a side project, and, you know, our favorite alternative rock band is Pearl Jam.
So you all did that thing with Pearl Jam.
We did that and with Sonic Youth.
No, I mean, when you actually, you know, look at it, do you actually think in a way the kind of gangster rap type thing and the themes, you know, with you know, songs like 8 of the K and, you know, those kind of things, that it's... It's kind of, I don't know, it's almost like you're giving a ready-made image there, so it's easy to market you in a way.
Well, basically, we try not to fall under the gangster image, you know, because we speak from a standpoint that any individual can live life as a gangster, and it don't mean that he has to be a criminal. It just means that, you know, you will protect yourself by any means, and you won't let anybody, you know, do you wrong. So basically, that's what the message we're trying to send out is, don't be a victim. Uh-huh. You know, not go out and cause the trouble and, you know, do unnecessary things. You know, you want to live life prosperous, so you leave well enough alone with people. And I think that, you know, you can get along with people. But, you know, we don't speak on the gang standpoint where you got to have all your boys around. Uh-huh. To feel like a man, you know, you got to be a man when your boys ain't around.
Okay, listen, I'm being pushed on now. We'll talk more about this later. Meanwhile.